हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम नारायण पवार। आई हैव प्रिपेयर दिस ऑनलाइन वीडियो ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ इंट्रावेनस जनरल एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट और इंजेक्टेबल जनरल एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग इनहेलेशनल जनरल एनेस्थेटिक्स एजेंट। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंट्रावेनस जनरल एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट्स। आई एम वर्किंग एट श्री प्रकाश चंद जैन कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी एंड रिसर्च पलास खेड़े। देन नेक्स्ट, अल्ट्राशॉर्ट एक्टिंग एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट। जनरली अल्ट्राशॉर्ट एक्टिंग जनरल एनेस्थेटिक्स एजेंट्स आर बारबिट्यूरेट्स। द बारबिट्यूरेट्स एक्ट थ्रू आउट द सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम्स। बारबिट्यूरेट्स एक्टिंग ऑन सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम्स, इट्स प्रोड्यूसेस अ जनरल एनेस्थीसिया। हाउएवर they exert most of their characteristics CNS effects mainly by binding to an allosteric recognition site on GABA A receptors. Means the ultra short acting barbiturates act on a GABA A receptor to produce a general anesthesia. GABA A receptors are inhibitory in nature. After the barbiturates act on GABA A receptors, it's open the chloride ion channels and influx the chloride ions inside the nerve cells and produces the hyperpolarizations of nerve cells to produce a general anesthesia. Means barbiturates generally act to produce their inhibitory actions by acting on the allosteric recognition site on the GABA A receptors. In the barbiturates are the sodium salt of the ultra short acting barbiturates may be administered intravenously in aqueous solution to induce anesthesia. Means the ultra short acting barbiturates are present in a salt form with a sodium and it is administered through the intravenously and giving the sodium salt of barbiturates given in a aqueous solution and administered through the intravenously to produce a anesthesia. The mainly volatile and the barbiturates are generally for the induction of anesthesia, not a maintenance. By maintenance of the anesthesia, mainly volatile anesthetics are used containing with or without nitrous oxide are used. Means the ultra short acting barbiturates are generally useful for the inducing the anesthesia, not a maintenance of the anesthesia. By maintenance of anesthesia, we have to use a volatile anesthetics or inhalational anesthetics agents. The respiratory depression is marked in the barbiturates when we are taking the treatment regarding general anesthesia containing the agents are barbiturates. Barbiturates shows a respiratory depression is marked with the barbiturates at an anesthetic doses. Barbiturates shows anesthetic doses a respiratory depression. Then unconsciousness is produced within a seconds. After giving the barbiturates, unconsciousness is produced within a seconds. of intravenous injection, and the duration of action is about 30 minutes, and the duration of the barbiturates is action are produced up to the 30 minutes and induces anesthesia within a seconds, and it produces their action up to the 30 minutes. Then the rapid onset of action is attributed. Barbiturates produces their action are rapidly because to rapid partitioning from the bloods. Barbiturates are partitioning from the bloods are rapidly and across the blood brain barrier into the site of action in the brain, and because of rapid partitioning from the bloods is crosses the blood brain barriers, and it produces their action through the brain. The very short duration of action is attributed to repartitioning from the brain. After the reaching of barbiturate in the brain, they show their action, and the brain from their repartitioning from the brain into peripheral tissues, initially to well perfused tissue, it perfused into the tissues and subsequently to the body fats, and it is perfused in the body tissues and produced their effects, anesthetic effects, peripherally effects. Then some example of ultra short acting drugs used to produce general anesthesia that are methohexital sodium, thymidyl sodium and thiopental sodium. These are the example of injectable ultra short acting anesthesia containing barbiturates. This is the basic structure of barbiturates. This was barbiturate, in that the barbituric acid, generally structure of barbituric acid is like this one. This is the structure of barbiturate. In the barbituric acids, at the second, fourth and sixth positions are ketone or trioxyl group are present. This is the structure of barbituric acid. This one carbon number 1, this position is second, this one third, this is fourth, and this one is a fifth. This carbon is fifth. By the substituting the H group on the position of number 1 at a nitrogens, at the second positions there are some lipophilic groups are substituted by oxygen, like a sulfur. Sulfur are more lipophilic than a oxygen. And at a third position, this hydrogen are replaced. The bond of N and H are shifted towards this one, and the sulfur or oxygen groups are form the salt with a sodium. This carbon valency has completed. At the fifth position, the di substituted, the substitution of 5 and 5 dash are 5 dash. This is the structure of barbituric acids. Barbituric acids are substituted at a different position. Position 1, at a position 1, some alkyl groups are substituted, generally in a methohexidals are methyl groups. At second position, some lipophilic groups, higher lipophilic than oxygen, are sulfur groups are substituted. And the third position, there are no substitution, but the shifting of this bond on the nitrogen carbon to produce double bonds. And at the fourth position, there is no substitution, and sixth position also not a substitute. But the fifth position, there are some alkyl groups, allyls or isopropyl pentyls in groups are substituted to produce a anesthesia or ultra short acting anesthesia, because it produces a highly lipophilic in nature. Let's start with the one by one drugs. In the general, this is the general structure of ultra short acting barbiturates. In that, first example is methohexital sodium. In the methohexital sodium, at the first positions, R1s are methyl groups, means hydrogen are replaced by methyl groups, and R2 means oxygens, same, and the H groups, this one substituted. At fifth positions, there is propyne, R5, this one is a propyne, and iodas is a isopentynyl, or fifth position containing trine groups are substituted. It is the example of methohexital sodium. And second one is a thymidyl sodium, at the this containing the oxygen on the second positions are replaced by sulfurs, and R1 is a H. Then third example, thiopental sodium, in that fifth positions ethyl groups are substituted, and second one is the isopentyl groups are substituted on the fifth positions, and the second positions are sulfur group are substituted by oxygens, and the hydrogen are as it is there. This is the general structure of ultra short acting barbiturate, and there some substitution on the R1, R2 and R5 positions. Then the first example of ultra short acting barbiturates containing drugs is methohexital sodium. The sodium salt of methohexitals, this is the structure of methohexital sodium. The IUPAC nomenclature of methohexital sodium is sodium 5-hex-3-ene. This is the 5-hexane, hexane containing, means hex means 6 carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 5-hex-3-ene at a 1, 2, 3rd position. Triple bonds, that YN. And second position methyl groups, 2-ene. At the 1 position, methyl groups, and 4 and 6 position, diazo. At the 5th position, there is 3 carbon propane, 2-ene. At the 2nd position, there is enyl pyrimidine. This is the structure of pyrimidines. And 2nd position are to form a salt with the oxygen, sodium, that's why oleate. The IUPAC nomenclature of methohexital sodium is a sodium 5-hex-3-ene, 2-ene, 1-methyl, 4,6-diazo, 5-prop, 2-enyl pyrimidine, 2-olate. The methohexital sodium induces deep sedation. Methohexital sodium induces deep sedation. Then it is used to induce anesthesia for short surgical procedure. Methohexital sodium used to induce anesthesia for short surgical treatment, diagnostics or therapeutic procedure associated with a minimum painful stimuli. Then methoxyethyl metabolized by demethylation and oxidation. Metabolism of methoxyethyl sodium generally by the demethylation and oxidation pathway or oxidative pathway or demethylation pathway. Then the methoxyethyl sodium generally excreted by the kidney. It is half life is 5.6 minutes. Methoxyethyl sodium general anesthetic agents half life is 5.6 minutes. Then next drug is thymidyl sodium. This is the structure of thymidyl sodium. It's act as a ultra short acting barbiturate. Their IUPAC nomenclature is sodium 4,6 at a 4 and 6 positions are dioxo group are present, 5 pentane 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At a 5th position 5 pentane 2 ethyl, at a 2 position methyl group 2 ethyl, 5 propane 2 enyl. This is a ethene containing propene group are attached at the 5th position, that's why prop 2 enyl. 1 hydro, here is hydrogen are absent, that's why 1 hydro pyrimidine. This is the structure of pyrimidine. At a second position thio, sulfur group are attached because of thiolate. This is the structure and the IUPAC nomenclature of thymidyl sodium is a sodium 4,6 dioxo 5 pentanol 2 ethyl 5 prop 2 enyl 1 hydro pyrimidine 2 thiolate. It has a sedative, anticonvulsant and hypnotic effects. Thymidyl sodium produces a sedative, anticonvulsant and hypnotic effects. It is used in the combination with acetaminophen, aspirin or caffeine. It used in the combination with acetaminophen, aspirin or caffeine for its sedative and relaxant effects. Thymidyl sodium are having a sedative and relaxant effects, that's why it is used in combination with acetaminophen and aspirin or caffeine for the treatment of tension, headache, migraine and pain. In the treatment of tension, headache, migraine and pain, the thymidyl sodium are used in combination with acetaminophen, aspirin or caffeine. Then the next drug is thiopental sodium. Thiopental sodium, it is acting as a ultra short acting barbiturate. It is a injectable drugs. This is the structure of thiopental sodium. The IUPAC nomenclature of thiopental sodium, at a 5th position ethyl group are present, this one 4 and 6 positions are dioxo and 5th position is pentane, 5 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon chain are present, that's why 5 pentane. At a 2nd position methyl group are attached to ethyl. At a 1 position there is no hydrogen, that's why 1 hydro pyrimidine. This is the structure of pyrimidine. At 2nd position thio sulfur group are attached thiolate. The IUPAC nomenclature of thiopental sodium is a sodium 5 ethyl 4,6 dioxo 5 pentane 2 ethyl 1 hydro pyrimidine 2 thiolate. It is a prototype of ultra short acting anesthetic barbiturates. Thiopental sodium are as a prototype of the ultra short acting anesthetics of barbiturates. It is used in the neurosurgical patients to reduce increased intracranial pressures. Thiopental sodium reduces the intracranial pressure, increases above the normal pressure of intracranial. It is reduced by the thiopental sodium. That's why thiopental sodiums are used in the neurosurgical patients. Then it produces a hypnosis within a 30 to 40 seconds when given in intravenous injection. Generally thiopental or all barbiturates are given to IV, given through a IV. It is produces hypnosis within 30 to 40 seconds. Then next type of anesthesia, injectable anesthesia, that is dissociative anesthesia. We have learned a ultra short acting anesthesia, that ultra short acting anesthetic agent, that is barbiturates. The barbiturates containing thiminal sodium, thiopental sodium and methoxyethyl sodium. The next type of injectable anesthesia is a dissociative anesthesia. In that, the example is ketamine hydrochloride. This is the structure of ketamine hydrochloride. The IFEC nomenclature of ketamine hydrochlorides. One second position. At a second position, 2-chlorophenyl. This one rings. 1 and 2 means second positions. 2-chlorophenyl group are attached. At a second positions, methyl amino group are attached, and this is a cyclohexanol and hydrochlorides. Means IFEC nomenclature of the ketamine hydrochloride is a 2-chlorophenyl-2-methylamino-cyclohexanone because of ketone group and hydrochlorides. This is the example of dissociative anesthesia. Ketamine hydrochlorides are example of dissociative anesthesia. Ketamine hydrochlorides are given through the as a injectables. It produces a hallucinogenic effects like phencyclidines. Ketamine produces a hallucinogenic effects like a phencyclidines. Or one more things, the ketamine are present as a racemic mixtures. This one carbons in the structure are produces a chiral centers because of this is present in a racemic form, R and S form. Then it induces dissociative anesthesia characterized by profound analgesia, immobility, amnesia with light sleep. Means ketamine hydrochlorides produces a dissociative anesthesia. Dissociative anesthesia means general dissociative anesthesia characterized by producing a analgesia, immobility, amnesia with light sleep. And the patient appears to a conscious. In the dissociative anesthesia, the patient should be a conscious and it's having a profound analgesic effect, immobility, amnesia with a light sleep. Amnesia means a partial or completely loss of memory. Then site of action of the dissociative anesthesia, it's act on a cortex or subcortical areas by acting through the NMDA receptor. It's inhibit the NMDA receptor action or block the NMDA receptors action. NMDA receptors are excitatory in nature. It produces the depolarization by influencing the sodium and calcium ions inside the nerve cells, because the influencing the sodium and calcium ions into the nerve cells, it produces a depolarization. By the NMDA receptor inhibitions or blockings, there are stoppage of the sodium and calcium ions influencing in the nerve cells to produce a hyperpolarization effect. Means the dissociative anesthesia containing ketamine hydrochlorides act or inhibited the excitatory neurotransmitter by the acting on the NMDA receptors to produce a hyperpolarization of nerve cells. The dose of ketamine hydrochloride through the intramuscular 5 to 10 milligram per kg are required, or in intravenously 1 to 2 milligram are required for producing the anesthesia. Then the S form of ketamine is 2 to 3 times more potent than the R form of ketamine as an analgesic effects. Means the analgesic effect of the ketamines are more potent in the form of S. Then the ketamine is metabolized via the pathway is N-demethylation to form the pain metabolite to the norketamines. The ketamine is metabolized via the N-demethylation produces a norketamines. Used in operation of head and neck, generally ketamine used in the operation of head and neck in a asthmatic patients, because ketamine produces a bronchodilation effects also. That's why on the operation of head and neck, if the patient having a asthma, ketamine are preferred for the patient containing asthmatic patients on the operation of head and neck. Then it may be dangerous for hypertensive. It is dangerous used for the treatment the patient containing hypertension, ischemic heart disease, congestive heart failure, because ketamines are characteristics of sympathetic nervous system stimulations. Ketamine produces a sympathetic nervous system stimulation because the sympathetic nervous system stimulation increases the heart rate, blood pressure and cardiac outputs. By the stimulation of sympathetic system, it increases the heart rate, blood pressure and cardiac outputs. That's why if the patient having hypertension, ischemic heart disease, congestive heart failure, in that cases the ketamine use are dangerous. And it is also in the those with rise intracranial pressure, that patients are also dangerous, because ketamine increases the cerebral blood flow and oxygen consumption. It is good for hypovolemic patients. Ketamines are good in the treatment of the patient having the hypovolemic patients. Here the injectable anesthesia containing ultra short acting barbiturates and dissociative anesthesia, the example is ketamines, are completed. Then the some purpose of general anesthesia. Why we use the general anesthesia? To get relief of pains. General, the medical term is analgesia. To get the relief of pain, the purposes of general anesthesia, to loss of memory on the procedure, it is a amnesia. Amnesia means the patient should be a loss of their memory. during the procedure. That's why we are using a general anesthesia. Next one, to produce a unconscious patient, the patient produces a unconsciousness for producing their operation or surgery. In that situation, the patient should be a unconscious. To inhibiting the normal body reflexes in the surgery times, the patient should be there, some normal body reflexes are should be inhibited. And to make the surgery safe and easier performance and relax the muscle of the bodies, to relax the muscles of the bodies. That's why these reasons, all this, that reasons we are using the general anesthesia. This is the purpose of general anesthesia. Then some complications of anesthesia. In case of during the anesthesia means the treatment are proceeding in the given anesthesia, that time some complications are occurs, that are the respiratory depression, salivation, respiratory secretions, cardiac arrhythmias, falling blood pressure, laryngospasm, and asphyxia, awareness, delirium, and convulsions. These complications are occurs during the anesthesia. And after the completion of anesthesia, some complications occurs that are nausea, vomiting, persisting sedation, pneumonia, and cognitive defects, and so on, etc. These are some complications occurs in anesthesia treatment. Some pre-anesthetic medications are used for anesthetic patients. Some pre-anesthetic medications are, it is the term applied to the administration of an anesthetic agents to make anesthesia safer and more agreeable to the patient. Because these reasons, pre-anesthetic medications are given to the patients. Why pre-anesthetic medication are given to the patient? Because of the to make the anesthesia safer and more agreeable to the patients. The pre-anesthetic medications are produces some effects, like for the safer anesthesia, to relieve of anxiety, to produces amnesia for pre and post operative events, it produces analgesia, decreases secretion, antiemetics effects, it produces antiemetic effects, and decreases the acidity and volume of gastric juice. That's why we are giving the pre-anesthetics medications. Some drugs used as a pre-anesthetics, the example, the categories containing pre-anesthetics agents in the blue colors, they are shown. The anxiolytics and sedative, example of anxiolytic and sedatives are diazepam, lorazepam, midazolam, and promethazine. The next category of amnesia producing, the example is lorazepam. Anticholinergic agents are atropines, antacids, H2 blockers. Antacids are ranitidine, famotidine, famotidine. Antiemetics drugs are metoclopramide, domperidone. Opioid analgesics are morphine and its congeners. These are some categories of drugs, or some example of drugs are used as a pre-anesthetics agents. Thank you guys, thank you so much.